Prashant's maths. Okay, I think it is our second class. In the first class we have passed through the definition of arithmetic sequence and the way how can we find out whether the given sequence is an IS or not. Now all of you have an idea about the common difference of an IS. Okay, in this class we are passing through the topic midterm of an IS. Yes, how can you find out the midterm? Yes, here you are given an IS. IS is equal to 41, 51 dots. You have wanted to find out the midterm of this AS. That is, how can you find out the midterm? Here we have a formula for finding out the midterm of AS. That is, first of all, we can take it as A, first term as A, second term as B and third term as C. Here you know B is equal to A plus C by 2. This is the formula for finding out the midterm of AS. B is the midterm. A and C are the first and third terms of this AS. Here the formula is B is equal to A plus C by 2. That is 41 plus 51 by 2. That is 92 by 2. That is 46 is its second term. That is midterm. Here AS is equal to 41, 46, 51, dots. Here we got an AS with common difference 5. 41 plus 5, 46. 46 plus 5, 51 and so on. Now you got a formula for finding out the midterm of the AS. Yes. Then we can enter into the next question. All of you write down the next question. AS is equal to 31, 29 dots. 31, 29 dots. Here also you are wanted to find out the midterm, that is middle term. Here it is the second term. How can you find out the second term? Yes, I have already told you, here it is taken as A, it is B and it is C. Here the formula is B is equal to A plus C by 2. That is A 31 plus 29 by 2. That is 60 by 2. That is 30. 60 by 2 is equal to 30. That is A plus C, 31 plus 29. Yes, 30. Here B is equal to 30. B is equal to 30. Yes. Here AS is equal to 31 comma 30 comma 29 comma dots. It is an AS with common difference. Here D is equal to x2 minus x1. That is 30 minus 31. That is minus 1 is the common difference here. Got it? Yes. In this way we can find out the common difference after finding out the AS. Here AS is equal to 31 comma dash comma 29 comma dots. You are wanted to find out the midterm. That is, midterm is taken as B. B is equal to A plus C by 2. That is 31 plus 29 by 2. That is 60 by 2 is equal to 30. The same problem can be done in another way. Ready to listen? Yes. Here you know. First term, that is x1. Here it is x1. Here it is x1. This is x2. And this is x3. How can you find out x2? Second term. Second term is equal to x1 plus x3 by 2. The same. We can formulate the formulas in any way. Whatever it is, we want to get the answer. And there should be a logic inside. That's all. Here, I took the formula x2, that is equal to x1 plus x3 by 2. That is 31 plus 29 by 2. That is same, 60 by 2. That is equal to 30. In this way, we can find out the midterm of the given AS. Okay. Then write the next question. Next topic. Mentioned terms of AS. Mentioned terms of AS. Mentioned terms of AS. Listen, all of you, please come to the class again. Here you are wanted to find out the mentioned terms of AS. For example, I am going to give you a question. AS is equal to 21, 28, 35, comma dots. Find its x31, that is 31st term and 101th term. How can you find out it? Now we have no idea. Now we are not having any idea. But first of all, you just pass through the question. In any case, we want to study the question well. Then we can formulate the ideas. Okay. AS is equal to 21, 28, 35, comma dots. You are wanted to find out its x31 and x101. That is 101th term. At the beginning I am saying, here AS is equal to 21 comma 28 comma 35 comma dots. Here x1 is equal to 21. Listen very seriously. x1 is equal to 21. Then what should be its x2? x2 means second term. Second term is equal to first term plus common difference. That is 21 plus What is its common difference? 7. 21 plus 7, 28. 28 plus 7, 35. That's why? Yes, 7 is its common difference. 21 plus 7, 28. Correct? First term got, second term got. Third term, x3. x3 is equal to f plus. Here, first term is equal to 21 plus d, 28 plus another d, 35. That is, one d is added here, another d is added here. That is, we are adding 2 d's for getting the third term. That is, f plus 2d. F plus 2d means 21 plus 2d, 2 into 7. That is, 21 plus 14. That is equal to 35. Yes. Now we got 35 as its third term. In the same way, we can find out its x4. x4 is equal to 1d is added, 2d is added, 3d is added. That is, total 3d's are added to the first term. That is, f plus 3d. That is, 21 plus 3 into 7. That is, 21 plus 3 into 7, 21. That is, 42 is its fourth term. Yes, correct. 35 plus 7, 42. Then, if x1 is equal to f, x2 is equal to f plus d. That is, 2 minus 1d. That is, d. Then, x3 is equal to f plus 2d. Got it? Then, x4 is equal to f plus 4 minus 1. That is, 3d. Got it? Got it? In this way, we can find out any terms of the AS. I think you can follow me very well. Okay. In this way, we can find out any term of this AS. Just I have told you the same thing. Now, x4 is equal to f plus 4 minus 1d. That is, 4 minus 1d is equal to 3d. 21 plus 3 into 7. That is, 21 plus 21. That is, 42. What should be its x11? x11 is equal to f plus. If 11 is here, how many d's should be added? 11 minus 1d. That is, 10d. Yes, that is, 21 plus 10 into 7. That is, 21 plus 70. That is, 91 is its 11th term. Got it? In the same way, we can find out any term, that is x21. What should be its 21st term? That is f plus, if 21 is here, how many d's should be added? 21 minus 1d, that is 20d. That is equal to first term 21 plus 20 into 7. That is 21 plus 140. That is 161 is its 21st term. In this way, we can find out its x101 or x100. What should be its 100th term? What should be the 100th term of this AS? So easy. That is, f plus 100 minus 1, 99. F plus 99d. That is, first term f is 21 plus 99 into 7. That is, 21 plus 99 into 7. Yes. Now, 693 plus 21, that is equal to 714 is its 100th term. In this way, using this formula, we can find out any term of any AS. Okay, yes, write the next question, all of you, please. Write the next question. Here the caption is mentioned terms of AS. Mentioned terms means the denoted terms. Listen, specially mentioned terms. AS is equal to 30, 27, 24, dots. Find its x25 and x101. Here is the question. x25 and x101. Very simple. x25 is equal to, tell me the formula, f plus how many d's? 25 minus 1d, that is 24d. Yes, here first term is equal to 30 plus 24 into, what should be the common difference here? Second term minus first term, d is equal to x2 minus x1, that is equal to 27 minus 30, that is equal to minus 3. If you are subtracting the greater number from the smaller number, answer should be negative. I think all of you know that because you are all 10th standard students. Okay, 27 minus 30, that is minus 3. Then we can substitute here minus 3 for D. That is 30. Here plus into minus, minus. 30 minus 24 into 3. 24 into 3. 72. 30 minus 72. That is 30 minus 72 is equal to minus 42. Minus 42 is its 25th term. I think all of you understood very well. Yes, you are given an AS, that is AS is equal to 30, 27, 24, comma dots. Then you are wanted to find out its 25th term and 101st term. Here x25 is equal to f plus, if 25 is here, how many d's should be added? 24d. 25 minus 1d. That is 30. Instead of f, you put 30. 30 plus 24 into minus 3. That is 30. Plus into minus, minus 72. 30 minus 72 is equal to minus 42 is its 25th term. I think all of you understood very well. Okay. Then come to the second sub-question, that is x101. x101, how can you find out taking formula? That is f plus 101 minus 1, that is 100d. Very simple. First term 30. 30 plus 100 into d, that is 100 into minus 3, that is 30. Don't put the plus here because plus into minus, minus 300. 100 into 3, 300. 30 minus 300, minus 270. Minus 270 is its 101st term. I think you can follow me very easily because I am passing through very simple ways. That's why. Okay. Now you are already given an AS, that is 30, 27, 24, comma dots. Here you are wanted to find out its 25th term and its 101, that is 101st term. x25 is equal to f plus 24d. F means first term. First term 30 plus 24 into minus 3. 30 plus into minus, minus. 24 into 3, 72. 30 minus 72, that is equal to minus 42. The minus 42 is its 25th term. Then in the same way, we can find out its 101st term. That is 1x101. Yes, x101 is equal to f plus 101 minus 1, that is 100d. That is 30 plus 100 into minus 3. That is 30 plus into minus, minus 300. 30 minus 300 is equal to minus 270. Is its 101th, that is 101st term. Okay, then come to the next question. Here is the next question, that is AS is equal to 3/4, comma 3/2, comma 9/4, comma dots. Give the AS of fractions. 3/4, 3/2, 9/4, comma dots. Find its x34 and x21. You are wanted to find its x34 and x21. Yes, we are having first term, that is f is equal to 3/4. Then d is equal to x2 minus x1. that is 3 by 2 minus 3 by 4, that is 3 fours are 12 minus 6 by 8, 12 minus 6 means 6 by 8, 6 by 8 is equal to 3 by 4, 3 by 4 is its common difference. I think you understood very well, very simple. First term 3 by 4, yes, it is already given directly. Then D, D means common difference, D is equal to x2 minus x1, that is 3 by 2 minus 3 by 4, 3 by 2 minus 3 by 4, we can do the cross multiplication here, that is 3 into 4, 12, minus 3 into 2, 6 by 8, 12 minus 6 is equal to 6, 6 by 8, after reduction 6 by 8 becomes 3 by 4. It is both are divisible by 2. 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8. That's why we are getting 3 by 4. I think you understood very well. Yes. Then you are now you are having both first term and common difference. Now then come to the formula. That is, you are wanted to find out its x34. X34 is equal to f plus 33d. F plus 33d. That is first term 3 by 4. 3 by 4 plus 33 into D. How much is the D here? 3 by 4. That is 3 by 4 plus 33 into 3. 33 into 3, I think 99 by 4. 99 plus 3. 99 plus 3 by the common denominator 4. That is 102. 102 by 4. 102 by 4. Yes. That is the 34th term. Yes. Once again I am passing through the same question. That is, you are wanted to find out its x34. X34 means f plus 33d. Am I correct? If 34 is the, then the 33d should be added. That is 34 plus, sorry, 3 by 4 plus 33 into 3 by 4. Here 3 by 4 is the common difference. Yeah, first term 3 by 4 and common difference is also the same. That's why first term plus 33 into 3 by 4. 3 by 4 plus 33 into 3, 99 by 4. Now the denominators are same. That's why we can do the direct addition. That is 99 plus 3 by the common difference, by the common denominator 4. 99 plus 3, 102. 102 by 4. 102 by 4 is its 34th term. Yes, it can be reduced to 51 by 2. Yes, 51 by 2 is its 51 by 2. Yes, 102 by 4 is reduced by 2. 102, 51 times 2. 4, 2 times. That is 51 by 2 is its 34th term. Then 21st term. X21 is equal to f plus 20d. F plus 20d. Here f is equal to 3 by 4 plus 20 into 3 by 4. Very simple. 3 by 4 plus 60 by 4. Am I correct? As the denominators are same, we can do the direct addition. That is 3 plus 60 by 4. That is 63 by 4 is its 21st term. That's all. Okay. All of you, warm welcome to our channel.